Now, one of the things I recommend to people for political magic are lodestone spells. Now, I normally associate lodestones with wealth work and love work, and that's definitely the case in Hoodoo. In Hoodoo, you take paired lodestones to attract your perfect mate or a new lover, and lodestones that are singly are usually associated with wealth. But lodestones can attract or repel anything you desire. So political lodestone altars are a perfectly viable option. And one way to do this is to have a lodestone altar to attract wealth to a political party. So you could take your lodestone and basically baptize and name it as you would an ordinary wealth lodestone, add a bit of iron pyrite, which represents wealth in its proximity, add a little bit of victory oil, maybe wealthy way oil, and then feed your lodestone weekly with pinches of iron filings as you would a prosperity lodestone, but the prosperity is being drawn to the political party of your choice or the candidate of your choice. Now, admittedly, the reason why I'm suggesting that this is be a political party rather than a candidate is that lodestones take sometimes about a year to work, and we don't have a full year. Now, another thing that you can do using the same kind of logic is by representing things using a slightly different symbology is to use lodestones to attract votes and attention. That would be involve using a crown of success oil and products like that to bring more attention towards your candidate. You also want to, when you set up a lodestone altar, have relics and petitions which are related to your goal. So one thing you might do is create a petition paper where you write the name of your candidate in unbroken script down seven times, seven is a lucky number, and then across what you want for them. More votes, more attention, some expression like that. And put that underneath your lodestone. Now, a friend of mine, Arthur Lipbonowitz, was able to score getting the natal chart of Ocasio Cortez. And that's another thing that you can do to support candidates. You can get their natal chart, since it's very hard for you to get the relic of a politician, like a sample of their hair or a drop of blood. But if you can get their natal chart, that can be used just as well as a way of directing power towards the political party or candidate of your choice. Obviously, you can't get the natal chart of a political party. That's ridiculous. Never mind. Anyway, but the idea is that you get a printout of the person's natal chart, you basically put maybe cinnamon or iron filings or something which represents what you want to draw to the candidate, then you fold the paper towards you, rotate it, fold it towards you, rotate it, fold it towards you, and then put that under the lodestone to draw good fortune to that person or that institution. Another thing you can do is you can enchant political leaflets. Now, in the Hoodoo formulary, there are things called sachet powders, which are much like the conditioned oils, but following similar formulas, except that they are impregnated into arrowroot powder or cornstarch, or in the olden days, talcum powder. And basically, they're scented powders which have been prayed over and have a spiritual function. If you take some of these sachet powders for appropriate purposes and put them on political leaflets, powder them at the top, and then use wavy lines to draw them towards you, and then dust it off, that becomes an enchanted political leaflet and will get more attention or whatever you want to project through that paper. Crown of Success sachet powder is really appropriate for that. Look Me Over is also really good for that.